ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، إن مما يجب على المؤمن أن يعتقد أنه مكتوب رزقه وأجله وعمله، وشقي أو سعيد، وهو في فضل أمه. عباد الله, from the first that is obligatory upon a Muslim to believe in is to believe with certainty that a person's provision, rizq, lifespan, actions, and whether his final destination is in paradise or hellfire, were all written down for him whilst he was in his mother's womb, as mentioned in the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud fi al-Sahihayn. And the term rizq can be defined as a person's sustenance, material provision in the form of money, jobs, marriage, and so on. A rizq can also be defined as anything that brings benefits or goodness to us. And from the affairs that is obligatory upon a Muslim to believe in is the saying of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَن تَمُوتَ نَفْسٌ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا وَأَجَلَهَا فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no soul will die until it has received its provision in full and has completed its lifespan. Therefore have taqwa of Allah and seek your sustenance in a most suitable way. And relative to this great hadith, Ibn al-Qayyim mentions in his book Al-Fawaid, you should feel yourself of doing that which has been demanded of you, meaning the worship and obedience of Allah must have been guaranteed for you, for provision and death are two matters that are destined and finalized. So long as the time of death has not arrived, the provision will continue to come. And here rahimahullah continues and he says, reflect on the state of the embryo, how it is fed from the blood of the mother through one path, the umbilical cord. Once it is born and that path is closed, two other paths, the breasts, are open for him through which nourishment is now provided, except that it's more delicious than what he used to receive from the first path. Thereafter, these two paths are closed upon weaning the child, but four paths of nourishment replace them, which are more perfect for the human being. Two food and two drink, meaning water and milk. Eventually, these two four paths are closed by a person dying. However, Allah will open if he is an inhabitant of paradise, eight paths. The eighth path in their stead, the eight paths of paradise to enter from whichever of them he pleases. And if man were just with his creator, which he is not, he would realize the favor of Allah on him by way of the worldly enjoyments that he deprived him of, and it being far greater than he would give him of his enjoyments. Indeed, he only deprived him in order to give to him, and he only afflicted him in order to heal him, and he only tested him to strengthen his bond with his creator, and he only put him to death in order to elevate him, and he only removed him from this world in order to meet him. وَلَا يَتَنَافَى هَذَا مَعَ الْأَخْذِ بِالْأَسْبَابِ. However, it is still upon a Muslim to take the means and to take the actions that will lead him to obtain his share of provision. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ. And in the heavens is your provision and what you are promised. And he's saying, subhanahu, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Indeed, Allah is the all provider, the firm possessor of strength. And he says, subhanahu, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. And there is no creature on earth except upon Allah, it's provision. So what are the means of obtaining provision and sustenance, ibadallah? Firstly, it is to strive to obtain a rizq, to work hard and to take the means. قال الله تعالى هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور. It is he who has made the earth subservient to you, so walk upon his path and eat of his provision, and to him is the resurrection. وقال عمر رضي الله عنه إن السماء لا تمطر ذهبا ولا فضة. And عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, he was reported to say, indeed the sky will not rain down gold and silver. So it is upon the Muslim to seek rizq by way of employment, trade and so forth. The Muslim should aim high and try to attain the skills required to network and so on. The Muslim is one who is proactive and has a high work ethic. This is how the Muslims of old were. The Salaf were ones who strive for their worldly affairs as well as in their ibadah. Ibn Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه was reported to say, إني لأبغض الرجل أراه فارغا ليس في شيء من عمل الدنيا ولا عمل الآخرة. He was reported to say, indeed I hate to see a man idle, neither working for this world nor for the hereafter. And Hassan al-Basri, he said regarding the people that he met, he said they were more stingy concerning their time than they were concerning their money. They were people who were disciplined and were strict with their time. They would not be excessive in relaxation, as free time and love of comfort are the biggest causes of laziness. And from the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was reported to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-'ajzi wal-kasal. Akhrajahu fi as-sahihayn. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from inability and laziness. A very important dua for the Muslim who wants to be productive. And from the means of obtaining a rizq, ibadallah, is having taqwa of Allah in fulfilling His orders and refraining from His prohibitions. As Allah the Most High, He states, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And whosoever has taqwa of Allah, He will make a way out for him, and He will provide, and he will provide for him where he would never imagine. Meaning, whoever has taqwa of Allah in what He has commanded and avoid what He has forbidden, then Allah will make a way out for him from every difficulty, and will provide for him from resources he never imagined or thought about. And Allah Azza wa Jalla stated it in His noble book, وَلَوِ اسْتَقَابُوا عَلَى الطَّرِيقَةِ لَأَسْقَيْنَاهُمْ مَاءً غَدَقًا. And if only they had believed in Allah and had istiqamah, steadfastness on the right way, we would surely have bestowed upon them water in abundance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And if the people of the town had believed and feared Allah, we would have indeed have opened to them all kinds of blessings from the heavens and earth. نَعْمْ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. From the means of attaining rizq is to stick to the orders of Allah and to distance oneself from the boundaries set by Allah. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيُحْرَمُ الرِّزْقَ بِالذَّنْبِ يُصِيبُهُ. إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيُحْرَمُ الرِّزْقَ بِالذَّنْبِ يُصِيبُهُ. indeed a man might be deprived from a provision because of a sin that he commits. And the person who has taqwa is a person who prioritizes his or her hereafter. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من كانت الدنيا همه فرق الله عليه أمره وجعل فقره بين عينيه ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له ومن كانت الآخرة نيته جمع الله له أمره وجعل غناه في قلبه وأتته الدنيا وهي راغب. Whoever makes the world his main ambition, Allah will scatter his affairs. وَأَتَدْهُ الدُّنْيَا وَهِيَ رَاغِمَةٌ. Whoever makes the world his main ambition, Allah will scatter his affairs and make poverty appear before his eyes. Meaning he will always feel poor, even if he is materially wealthy. And he will not get anything from this world, but except for that which has been decreed for him. However, whoever makes the hereafter his main ambition, Allah will settle his affairs and make him content in his heart, and the world will come to him, although he does not want it. Likewise, ibadallah, from the means of obtaining rizq is at-tawakkulu ala Allah, to rely on Allah, to trust Allah, and to call upon Allah for assistance in attaining rizq. Qala Allah ta'ala, وَمَن يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. And whomsoever puts his trust in Allah, Allah will suffice him. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informed us, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِهِ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرُ تَرْضُو خِمَاصًا وَتَرُوحُ بِطَانًا. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you were to rely on Allah as he should be relied on, he would provide for you as he provides for the birds. They go out early in the morning hungry, and they return in the evening full. قال ابن رجب رحمه الله. And Ibn Rajab, he states that this hadith is a foundation for at-tawakkul being a means of obtaining provision. Likewise, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informed us, إِذَا خَرَجَ الرَّجُلُ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ أَنْ يَقُولَ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ يُقَالُ لَهُ هُدِيتَ وَكُفِيتَ ووقيت وتنحى عنك الشيطان. ويقول الشيطان كيف لي برجل هدي وكفي. He صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whomsoever says when he leaves his house in the name of Allah, I have relied on Allah and there is no power, no strength except by Allah, he will be told, you have been guided, spared and protected, and shaytan will be kept far from him. And shaytan says to another shaytan, how can you get at a man who has been guided, spared and protected, ayyuhal mu'minun, from the means of obtaining a rizq is to make dua to Allah, to obtain a rizq, for indeed Allah is ar-razzaq, Allah is the all-provider. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, call upon me, I will respond to you. Indeed, those who disdain my worship will enter hell whilst they are in contempt. And from the dua of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the Fajr prayer, he would say, Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbala. Ayyuhal mu'minun, from the means of obtaining a rizq is to praise Allah, to be thankful, and to be grateful to Allah for all blessings a person has in their life. For indeed Allah has promised that He will increase your blessings if you are grateful. قال الله تعالى لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And when your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you in favor. But if you deny, indeed my punishment is severe. So be thankful to Allah for all your blessings and all goodness that you have obtained in your life. For indeed, gratefulness will increase you in goodness and bounties. And as shukr, gratefulness is actualized by fulfilling the commands of Allah and staying away from His purposes. أقول هذا القول وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه يغفر لكم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على خير خلق الله أجمعين، وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، from the means of obtaining rizq and being blessed in one's rizq is maintaining the ties of kinship, maintaining relations with one's close relatives. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم stated in the hadith, in the Sahih, من أحب أن يبسط له في رزقه وأن ينسى له في أثره فليصل رحمه. Whoever would like his provision to be increased and his lifespan extended, let him uphold the ties of kinship. And the people who are the most right for their relation to be maintained are the mother and the father. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, من أحق الناس بحسن صحابتي؟ قال أمك. قال ثم من؟ قال أمك. قال ثم من؟ قال أمك. قال ثم من؟ قال أبوك. ثم أدناك أدناك. أو Messenger of Allah, who is most deserving of my fine treatment? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, your mother, then your mother, then your mother, then your father, then your nearest, then nearest. So when the Muslim maintains by financially and emotionally supporting his relative and maintaining the ties of kinship, he will find barakah and blessings in his rizq. For Allah has promised that he will enlarge his rizq. Ayyuhal mu'minun. From the means of obtaining a rizq is to increase and to follow up between the performance of Hajj and Umrah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة فإنهما ينفيان الفقر والذنوب كما ينفي الكير خبث الحديد والذهب والفضة. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, follow up, تابعوا يعني أثروا and increase, follow up and increase the performance of Hajj and Umrah, because they certainly remove poverty and sins as fire separates the impurities from iron, gold and silver. So from the benefits of frequent performance of Hajj and Umrah are the removal of poverty and also the removal of sins. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. Just an announcement, inshallah, the Asr prayer will be the last prayer in the masjid before the masjid is closed, before the lockdown, inshallah. Atul Salaam. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية؟ وجوه يومئذ خاشعة
عاملة ناصبة تصلى ناراً حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
استغفر الله.